Yes, hi students, my name is Nirusha from Computer Department. So now I will be discussing a topic called Thevenin's Theorem. Yes, students. So what is so for Thevenin's Theorem? Yes, so the statement of Thevenin's Theorem says that for any linear electrical network, yes, consisting of voltage sources, yes, current sources and resistances can be replaced at the terminals by combining the voltage source, that is with the voltage, with Thevenin's voltage, yes, in series with our Thevenin's resistance and load resistance, yes. So let us understand this statement with the help of a diagram. Yes, so here I have taken a voltage source. Yes, so we keep the value for the voltage source as 10 ohms. Yes, and this is the resistance. Same value to be 2 ohms. Right, and here another resistance I have taken for this source I have taken 2 ohms. So I am taking it, you know, similar or equal resistance values in order to understand the concept in a very better way. Okay. And then here comes the load resistance. Yes, load resistance also taking as 2 ohms. Right? So just as I have told you, yes, the statement for Thevenin's theorem is a linear electrical network consisting of voltage source and resistances, yes, can be replaced at the terminal, yes, at the terminals by combining the VTH, that is Thevenin's voltage, and RTH, that is Thevenin's resistance, in series with load resistance. Here the load resistance is 2 ohms. Yes, same. Now we have to find out the load current angle. Right, we have to find out the load current angle. Now by applying Thevenin's theorem, how can we apply the load current angle across the load resistor R 2 ohms? Yes, so here we shall draw the Thevenin's network. Yeah, so this is our VTH. Right, and this is RTH. And this is our load resistor, 2 ohms. Okay? Now, we shall start the calculation part. So, step one is, when there is a presence of voltage source in a network, then you have to replace that voltage source with the short circuit. Right, and when there is a presence of current source, you have to open circuit. Yes, the presence of voltage source, short circuit. Right, in the presence of current source, open circuit. Yes. So now we have to apply this concept in step 1, and the most and important thing is, here the question is asking us to find out the load current across the load resistor RL. So we have to remove the load resistor RL. Okay, so the circuit will become as follows. Right, so this is the resistor, sorry, the network, what we have obtained. So here you can see that 2 ohms is in parallel with 2 ohms. Right? Here we have to find out the RTH. So what will the RTH, since it's a parallel connection owing to the same values, we can divide the resistance. Yes. So R divided by number of
branches. It is only applicable when the value of each and every resistor is same. So here R value is 2 ohms divided by 2, which is equal to 1 ohm. So therefore, our Rth value is 1 ohms. Okay? Now, how can you find out the Vth? Right? How can we find out the Vth? Now we shall rewrite the network diagram. Yes, Vs is equal to 10 volts. Yes or no? Yes. It is 2 ohms. This is ohms, right? Now, we have to find out Vth, right? Now, Vth. So, this is equal to Vth. So, here we can apply the voltage division rule, right? We can apply the voltage division rule. So, Vth is equal to, for the source voltage 10 volts is equal to voltage across the same resistance, that is 2 ohms divided by total resistance in the network. So, 2 plus 2. Yes, now add it up, how much will you get it? M into 2 divided by 2 plus 2 is 4. 2 2s are 4 and 2 5s are 10. So, it is 5. So, Vth value is 5 volts. Fine. Now, here we have the value of the source voltage, resistor, and the Thevenin's resistance and load resistance. Now, I think with the help of, now we have all the parameters required in the Thevenin's circuit. So, now we can find out the load current. So, the formula is IL is equal to Vth divided by Rth plus RL. So, it is equal to 5 volts divided by 2 plus 1, which is equal to 5 by 3 amperes. Okay, so this is the value of the current flowing through the load resistor 2 ohms. Okay, now we shall understand the concept with the help of one more circuit diagram. Thank you. 1. Now 2 plus 1 is 3. Now we have to reason argument. So therefore 3 by 3.